Hello everybody, Star here, and we're going to be talking about a delicate subject in Team Fortress 2. I know it's weird because this is such a lighthearted game that there can even be delicate subjects where people get, oh my word, I can't believe what he just said, I'm so offended. It's kind of like where in a video if somebody says, you know, PS3 is better than the Xbox 360, then all of the comments thereafter are, rabble, 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 rabble. I can't believe he just said that. But what we're going to talk about is actually random crit servers, which does create a divide in the Team Fortress 2 community where there are some people that say, random crit, you know, you have to play that, that's vanilla, that's the way TF2 was balanced, and then there are some people who say, no. Just no. So this is basically being explained for people who don't really know that they have an option, because here's where I come from, and where I'm trying to explain this from, is that when I first joined TF2, I of course didn't know anything about the game. I just joined a server, any server, because it didn't really make a difference to me which one I joined, they were all the same to me. I joined a random crit server because 90% of servers are random crit, and I joined a server from the very top of the list, which would be a 32-person server, which of course is also not really the default for TF2. It gets weirdly balanced at anything above 24 players. So, for a long time I was playing random crit, and it was the one thing that I truly disliked about the game, and I didn't really realize that no crit was an option, and that there were servers that ran the no crit option in general, so I just kind of stuck with it. And after a while, I kind of got fed up, and I said, you know what, this really isn't working for me. This is the one thing in TF2 that I just absolutely can't stand. It doesn't make any sense why this is in the game. And I did just start figuring out that, oh, there are no crit servers, but it took me a long time to actually start joining them, because my favorites list was entirely full of servers that were all random crit enabled, and it took a while to make the change. You know what I mean? So for anyone who doesn't really know the difference, I'm just going to explain it here, as unbiased as I can. I'm not unbiased on the subject, but I'm going to try and explain it. That on a random crit server, let's say you're using a rocket launcher and you fire a rocket. When you fire that rocket, there is a 2% chance that it will do 3 times the amount of damage, being a critical hit. Much like when a bullet comes out and you're being critscreaked, it will do 3 times the amount of damage. For no reason, just 2% chance. But there is also this mechanic a lot of people don't really know about, that if the amount of damage you've dealt in the last 20 seconds attributes to the chance of you getting a random critical hit up to 10% more. So you can get a maximum of 12% chance to shoot a random crit rocket. Though getting that much damage in 20 seconds is incredibly hard to do. It does not happen very often in gameplay. Usually you're just getting a slight bonus from the amount of damage you've dealt. I don't remember exactly the numbers on how to, you know, when it gets higher, but that does work. And melee weapons, you get a 15% base chance to do random critical hits, which, 15%, you know, there is a lot of leeway that it won't be one, but it seems like more often than not, they tend to be. So what happens on no crit servers is that chance is completely gone. That doesn't exist, but if someone uses a crit screeg, or you use a weapon that, you know, you can do critical hits where you throw Gerardi and then use the bush vodka, then you can still get that critical hit. It's just no random ones based on that mechanic. Another thing that random crit servers usually have is no damage spread and no bullet spread. And no crit servers usually disable them as well, so there is a little bit more than just that one thing. Where no bullet spread is if you fire a shotgun, all of the bullets go in completely random spots. I believe there is usually one bullet that goes straight down where you aimed, but all the bullets spread, thus bullet spread. And then there is also damage spread, where each pellet of that shotgun will do, there is a minimum damage they can do and a maximum damage they can do. And the chance of doing any number in between, or the maximum minimum, is completely random. It just basically picks a number out of a hat and says, okay, this is what you did this time. Same thing for all weapons, where if you shoot a rocket at somebody, the rocket hits them, it needs to pick what damage it actually does. Where on no crit servers, they usually have that disabled, where it does a set damage every time, as well as shotguns. Their pellets will always go in the exact same spot, so you can actually aim it and not just get lucky on where the pellets decided to land. And that is the true difference here, is that one is based on luck, where random crit servers are, you can get lucky and do something normally that you wouldn't be able to do, and no crit servers are more dependent entirely on what you've done and not what the game decides you did. And so my opinion on this, which I'm going to explain to the best of my abilities, and once again, it is my opinion, so if you disagree, and this is making you angry, please, you know, hold back on the "oh, sorry, I'm so offended, I can't believe you'd ever say that" type of comments where you're some grumpy old guy. Basically, the way I see it is that random crit servers are much more geared to the casual player, because you don't need a lot of gun skill to beat people who do have a lot of gun skill, where you can be completely outplayed by someone. They're, you know, dominating you. You only have one health left, and you just get lucky based on the fact that you got lucky, and by 2% chance, you are better than the person that you otherwise could not beat. So you get into less situations where you're like, oh, we can't win this, we can't do anything, they're so much better than us, because at a certain point, the amount of skill that the person you're fighting have might not matter based on you getting random crits. Where there have been many times where I've played on these types of servers, completely outplayed somebody, you know, I'm wrecking them, I know they're gonna die, I'm keeping a count in my head of how much health they have left, and I say, oh, there's no way they could possibly. And then they get random crits, and they had a chance to be better than me. Which is something I've never really agreed with, and I can't enjoy playing like that. Anything based on luck, I really don't feel like you should ever reward a player just for being luckier than the other person. In any way, in any game, it's much like X Factor, where random crits are the X Factor of this game, and oh, anybody can win now. You all have an equal chance, even if you're doing terribly. And so, the way I see it, there are two types of people that will enjoy random crit servers. And once again, it's cool if you're one of these two people. If you enjoy playing random crit, I'm not trying to harp on your fun, just keep doing it. But know that most of my commentaries will be coming from the no crit perspective of things. So first type of person is honestly someone who just doesn't care. Where they get killed by a random crit, they laugh it off. They kill someone with a random crit, they go on voice chat and laugh with their friend on an all talk server. It's all just very casual, haha, everything is fun and awesome. And it doesn't really matter, because they just don't care. And then the second type of person is someone who just might not know that it is something that can be cared about, or know that it exists, which I definitely used to fall into this category, where I didn't really understand random crits entirely. Where you could be in that scenario where you're complete, you know, soldier 1 versus 1, you're completely outplaying the other soldier, he's down to 1 health, you still have full because he's retarded and he missed every single rocket on you somehow, and then his last shot is a random crit, and you die. And if you don't know the mechanic entirely, and if you're new to the game or something, you could just say to yourself, oh, he outplayed me. You know, he just did better than I did, and I'm dead because of it. Where you don't know that you died completely by chance and completely by luck, and that there is an alternate option, where if you were playing on a no-crit server, you would have destroyed this guy, and he would have had no chance on you, and you only would have lost, you know, about 40 health if it was a rocket that didn't directly hit you. So, basically, that's the way I see it. And in my opinion, I will always continue to play no crit servers. Occasionally, I do play on random crit servers, and that is when I really just don't care as much. I'm somewhere in between where I can understand why you would play that, and I can understand why you wouldn't want to play it. I'm not hating on anyone. Ain't no Xbox PS3 arguments going on here. Oh my god, PS3 is better! I'm 13 years old! None of that. That's completely irrelevant. I don't even want to get into an argument like that, because to begin with, PC is better than all consoles anyway. And now I'm completely off topic, but I'm trying to make an example. Is that whether or not you play on random crit servers, or you don't play on random crit servers, TF2 is still better than Call of Duty. Thank you everybody for watching. This gameplay is about to end here, and I'm just gonna leave you with the very ending. So peace out everybody, I'll catch you guys later. You are defeated.